Now you tell me, is this an embarrassment or is it irrelevant? The president made an appearance at the Olympic meetings and the United States lost. 2016 games went to Rio. The president was there on behalf of Chicago. Some wondered if he should have gone at all. But after getting knocked out in the first round of the voting, apparently the answer is no. Is this embarrassing for the president? Don't you think if he shows up, you expect it to go our way if the president is there? Or is it simply a blip on the radar screen and means absolutely nothing, Ron?
Well, I think it's all part of the process that the president has been engaged in. He's gone all over the world and told people we're not the king of the earth anymore. This is part of the end of American imperialism. We've had that expectation, and you've defined it perfectly, that if we want it, we get it. Things haven't worked out that way. And the president, I think, is properly trying a new strategy of you know, putting the best foot forward, acting like any other nation, going there and making his pitch.
Going and making his pitch and looking like a loser.
Go ahead, Ruth.
I'm sorry, but I just think that, first of all, this is the first time a president of the United States has ever gone in person to plead his case before the Olympic Committee. And, you know, yeah, they said no. So now we just look like losers. Tony Blair was successful at this. He was a winner. He got the Olympics for London. But we just look terrible. And it's yet another nail in the Obama coffin. Luckily, everything else is going so well for him. Afghanistan, Iran, the healthcare program, everything's going great. He's got plenty of time to get back to his roots of greasy Chicago-style politics, where he thinks he can throw his weight around. Maybe if he'd worn a bikini, I don't know. But he didn't get it.
I just don't think if you're a smart person, and I'm not saying I am, you don't fight a fight you're not going to win. You don't show up there unless you're pretty darn sure.
Well, everything's been a slam dunk for Obama up until now.
America never had a chance. I mean, South America had never get a game.
Right, that's true.
The world was changing. And I think, I absolutely think America has to come down and act like every other nation. We are incredibly powerful. We are incredibly rich. But we have to treat everybody else in a more egalitarian way. And I think it's wonderful.
We've got our own problems.
The president went there and acted like any other president and made his pitch, and I think it's a great thing.
Well, I got to
think it's wonderful that it's right in time with his new policy limiting lobbyists. I mean, and then he goes there and lobbies.
Yeah, you know, I'm somewhat amazed because we're just not used to losing when the president shows up. I got to be honest with you. That doesn't work for us. That's not in our psyche. And if you're sitting here and saying, well, look, things have changed and we've all got to play nice with everybody in the sandbox and we're not always going to win, I think that goes against the way Americans feel.
Absolutely.
Well, we're spoiled. There's no doubt about it.
Completely. Completely. And 81% of people on a U.S. News poll said they were against this. They thought that this was a bad move on Obama's part. So, yeah, Fred, they agree with you, and so do I.
All right, let's move on here. So people are still talking about David Letterman's bizarre confession and the man who has been charged with extortion. Letterman admitted on TV that he had sexual encounters with members of his staff after Joe Halderman threatened to blow the whistle if Letterman didn't give him $2 million. Halderman is a producer for CBS News. He says, hey, I'm innocent. His attorney was on the Today Show this morning, and he says the real story will come out.
What this trial is going to be about, it'll all be about the surrounding circumstances, and that's what we.
What do you mean by the surrounding circumstances?
Well,
is it about his relationship with his
motives, and intent? And it's not only the motive, intent, and conduct of Joe Halderman; it's the motive, intent, and conduct of David Letterman as well. As I've said, I look forward to cross-examining David Letterman.
All right, so we know Halderman is in trouble. We know that David Letterman, by the way, you have not seen this yet, but tonight it's going to run in the East in about an hour. He is going to apologize to his wife for his extramarital affairs. Is Letterman in trouble? Can he laugh this one off, Ruth?
Well, I don't think he laughs anything off. I stopped watching Letterman years ago because he degenerated into some weird, creepy lech who was always sidling too close to actresses and saying stuff like, you smell nice. I mean, he's a weird guy, but I gotta say, if that $2 million wasn't for blackmail, I wanna know what it was for. Because he didn't just pitch him a script. I mean, when you pitch a script, it goes through your lawyer, it goes through your agent. I mean, we all know the process. This was not that process. I think Halderman thought that he wasn't going to get caught at this, which I don't know what on earth could have possessed him with such an idea. Letterman's a big, big boy and a heavy hitter, and there's no way he's going to go down easy like this.
Ron?
Well, let's see his top 10 list today. Not going to mess around with the hell. Number 9, I'm going to apologize every day for the rest of my life.
And that's disgusting, too.
It's absolutely the worst form of self-parody in a time when we're seeing all these icons of our culture without any sort of sense of place or purpose or common decency. I'm not talking about even morality. It's like, who do these people think they are? Because they have all this money, all this fame. I think there must be something incredibly, you know, viral about the poison of fame and wealth that really is something to look at. If David Letterman can't control himself with the help when he's, you know, not married that long, geez, I mean, who is he?
All right.
Wow. And does he think this is going to unhumiliate his wife if he goes on TV and apologizes to her?
No.
Oh, my God.
No. All right. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to give you each 10 seconds final word. Ron, I'm going to start with you. Does this have any impact on the David Letterman show, Late Night with David Letterman? Does it matter? Are people still going to watch? What do you think?
I think there's a lot of his fans who will be quite offended at it. On the level of, I haven't been amused by him for a very long time. I don't like Leno very much. I find him both kind of mediocre and passe, but it's certainly not going to help his ratings over time. He's going to lose people.
Ruth, what about you?
I think he's already lost the people he's going to lose, and he's going to keep the people he's going to keep. I think that, like I said, I quit watching him years ago. I think the show is boring and that he's awful. But I think that right now it's going to be a huge ratings boost. Everybody's talking about it. Everybody's watching the show. Everybody's TiVoing it. This is the best thing to happen to him in 10 years.
Ruth, Ron, nice job tonight. Thanks. We'll talk to you guys next week.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
See you, Ruth.
Okay.